Namaste, welcome to the session Routh Criteria with Special Cases. At the end of this session, students will be able to apply Routh Criteria for special cases and analyze the stability of system. Now in this session, we are going to see Routh Criteria with Special Case 1 and then Routh Criteria with Special Case 2. Now before proceeding further, pause the video here and recall Routh's criteria and how to write Routh's table for this equation. So I think you have recalled how to write Routh criteria. So for the given equation, we can write the Routh table, or it is also called as Routh array, as for s raised to n row, the coefficients are a0, a2, a4, a6, and then for s raised to n minus 1, a1, a3, a5, a7, the b1, b2, b3 calculated as, then next row s raised to n minus 3 is calculated for c1, c2, c3 as. Now again take a pause here and recall what is the stability condition of Routh's array. So I think you are recalled the stability condition of Routh's array or Routh's table. So the necessary and sufficient condition for a system to be stable is that all the terms in the first column of Routh's array must have same sign, and there should not be any sign changes in the first column of Routh's array. System is unstable if any sign change occurs in the first column. And the number of sign changes in the first column indicates number of roots in the right half of the S-plane. Now let us see Routh criteria with special case 1. So what is special case 1? So in the Routh table, if there is a 0 only in the first column of a row, or first element of any row of Routh array is a 0, and remaining row contains at least one non-zero element, then it is known as a special case 1. Now due to this, what happens is Routh test fails as a term in the new row becomes infinite. So we cannot find the stability of the system. So to overcome this, in the special case of Routh criteria, we have to replace 0 by epsilon and complete the Routh table, and then let epsilon tends to 0 and again analyze the stability from the number of sign changes in the first column of Routh table. Now let us have one example on the Routh criteria with special case 1. So for the given equation below, find out stability of the system. So for this equation, we can write the Routh table as, for s raised to 5 row, we have the coefficients here 1, 2 and 6. So for s raised to 4 row, we have the values as 3 and 6 and 9. So we can divide this row by 3. So we'll get 1, 2, 3, the new values after dividing s raised to 4 row by 3. Then for calculation of s raised to 3 values, so here 1 into 2, 2 minus 1 into 2, so 2 minus 2 is 0, divided by 1 is 0. So here in the first column of Routh array or Routh table, we have 0, and then in next value is 1 into 6 minus 1 into 3, that is 3 divided by 1, we'll get 3 here. So according to the special case 1, if we have a 0 in the first column only and only one 0 is there, then what we have to do is we have to consider 0 as epsilon and 3 as it is for the row s raised to 2, we have here 2 into epsilon minus 3 divided by epsilon, and 3 into epsilon minus 0, because there is no value here, divided by epsilon, then we have 3 here. For the s raised to 1 row, the next value is 3 minus 3 epsilon square divided by 2 epsilon minus 3. So after calculating this, we will get this value. The next value will be 0. For the s raised to 0 row, we will get 3 value here. So once table is over, so limit epsilon tends to 0, 2 epsilon minus 3 divided by epsilon will give us minus infinity. And for the s raised to 1th row, limit epsilon tends to 0, 3 minus 3 epsilon square divided by 2 epsilon minus 3 will give us plus 3 here. So what we can observe from the first column of Routh table, we have the values as 1, 1, then epsilon, minus infinity, plus 3, and 3. So if we observe here, we have first sign change from positive to negative, then second sign change negative to positive. So what we can conclude here is there are two sign changes, so the system is unstable with two poles in the right half of the S plane. So this is how Routh criteria with special case 1 is solved. Now let us see Routh criteria with special case 2. The Routh table get fills when there is an entire row that consists of zeros. So to overcome Routh criteria with special case 2, we have to form the auxiliary equation from the above row of the row which consists of all the zeros. Then we have to differentiate the polynomial with respect to S and replace the row of zeros by its coefficient. Then we have to continue the construction of the Routh table and then analyze the stability from the number of sign changes in the first column. So let us have example on Routh criteria with special case 2. So for the given equation, is the system stable? So we have this equation, and from this equation the Routh table is written as, for the first row s raised to 6, we have the values 1, 8, 20 and 16. For the s raised to 5, we have the values as 2, 12, 16, and there is no further, so 0 here. So in the second row, that is s raised to 5, we can divide each value by 2, so the new values comes here 1, 6, 8. So to find out the next row values, that is s raised to 4, so it is nothing but 8 minus 6 divided by 1 gives us 2, then 1 into 20, 20 minus 8, 12, divided by 1, 12, then further value is 1 into 16 minus 0, that is 16 here. So we have s raised to 4 row values as 2, 12, 16, so again dividing this row by 2 will give us new values as 1, 6, 8. Then for the next row, s raised to 3, the values will be 1 into 6, 6 minus 1 into 6, that will give us 0. So here we get 0. Then further value, 1 into 8 minus 1 into 8, that will be 0 again. So if you observe here, s raised to 3 row consists of all the zeros. So according to the Routh criteria with special case 2, we have to write the auxiliary equation from the above row of the row which is consisting of all the zeros. So here equation becomes s raised to 4 plus 6x square plus 8. So further moving to the solution, we have to differentiate this equation. So that will give us 4s cube plus 12s, and then replacing these zeros by the coefficients of differential equation as 4 and 12. So here for s raised to 3 row, we have to consider new values as 4 and 12. Now further simplifying this, we can divide this row by 4, that will give us 1 and 3. So let us calculate the values for s square, that will give us 1 into 6 minus 1 into 3 divided by 1, that will be 3, and next value will be 1 into 8 minus 0 divided by 1, that will give us 8. So further calculating values of s raised to 1 and s raised to 0 will give us 1 by 3 and 8. Now if you observe this column, first column of the Routh array, we have all the values positive, 1, 1, 1, then 1, 3, 1 by 3, 8. But we have to solve this auxiliary equation, then that will give us s is equal to plus minus j root 2 and s is equal to plus minus j 2. So by observing these values, we can conclude that the system is marginally stable. So in this way, we can solve the Routh criteria for the special case 1 and 2. These are references. Thank you.